Welcome to your first opening of Reason 5. Once you've placed the disk inside your computer, an option will appear to take the Reason application folder and drag it and then copy it into your computer's application folder. You will likewise need to copy the factory and orchestra sound banks into the Reason folder on your computer's application folder. This process will be quite similar to a PC. Let's go to the application folder now. Here you can see I've got Reason in my computer applications folder, and inside that folder I have my factory and my application and orchestra sound banks already copied. Likewise, there is documentation, video tutorials, and many more files that you will need to make music with Reason. The demos folder has inside it, as you follow this path, the three files we will be analyzing as we start the Reason project-based learning creations tutorials. They're highlighted in orange, and as you can see, they're named by composer and title of the song, and they are published files designated by the .rps. As we open up the demo file Stay by the Phone, we get our first look at Reason 5's interface. Starting with the Reason rack, at the top we have the mixer and all the devices listed below. If you toggle the tab key, you get to see the cabling for every device in the Reason rack straight back into the mixer. Below we have the sequencer window. The sequencer window contains all the MIDI data that you will need to compose and rearrange the works we look at. The bottom has the transport controls: stop, play, record, tempo, time signature, and of course the ever important loop button. Let's have a look at a few more features, but first let's play this demo song Stay by the Phone. As I turn down the main fader, so you can hear my voice, I'll point out a few more features. Up the top at the window menu, we can detach the sequencer window, there is a separate tool window, and on-screen piano keys. As I first detach the sequencer window, you can see that right now, we can see every single instrument apart from the Reason rack. It's quite handy to detach that sequencer window and put it next to the Reason rack. That way you can see your MIDI data and all the devices that are playing those sounds beside each other. If I open the tool window, we see our quantize controls, our transposition controls, and many other unique features that are built into Reason 5. Another fantastic feature of Reason 5, if you don't have a connected USB MIDI keyboard, you can use the on-screen piano keys either with your mouse or with your QWERTY keyboard to play in notes for each device listed in the rack. Another vital feature is the Reason Help menu. There are also video tutorials and tutorials at the Propellerhead website. But once you open the Reason Help menu, you are presented with a complete list of every device, technique, and anything you'll ever need for operating Reason 5. Throughout the course, you will need to refer to this menu multiple times for things such as programming drum kits, how to add effects, how to recable the device, and if you do get lost, you can use the index and search menus to help you. That was your first opening of Reason 5. Continue with videos 3, 4, and 5 as you explore more devices and techniques in Reason PBL Creations.